welcome to our show of shows. It is my great honour to introduce this evening's renowned guest. The one, the only, Mary Poppins!
Mary Poppins. No, I couldn't possibly. D flat major. Some people like to splash and play. Can you imagine that? And take a seaside holiday. Can you imagine that? Too much glee leaves rings around the brain. Take that joy and send it down the drain. Some people like to laugh at life and giggle through the day. They think the world's a brand new shiny toy. And if while dreaming in the clouds they fall and go kasplat, although they're down and bent in half, they brush right off and start to laugh. Can you imagine that?
If you ring with something broken on a Thursday, I'll make new with my glue, pins and thread. But you bring where I've broken on a Friday, I will mend and then spend the day in bed. Children, Saturdays and Mondays are just everything is fun days. But in the second week I wear a frown. For I'm Lord and after Tuesday comes the Topsy gets bad news day. It's the dreaded second Wednesday. But from 9 to noon my life turns upside down. Being is young, peace and quiet, storm of drink. Tuesday nights my blood begins to curdle. East is west, in is out, and that is why I need to shuffle or go. The world is turning to fall. Oh, if you had come some other morn, you wouldn't have found me so forlorn. But since the day that I was born, second fancies is on the fritz. I couldn't mend this to save my soul. If this keeps up, I'll dig a hole. You say life's a cherry bowl, but Wednesday's full of pit.
Tell us, can you fix this drum?
Well, today's looking glam.
Can you mend this crack and broken string?
Now perhaps if you all lend a hand.
Our fingers are at your command.
A broken songbird still can sing.
Let's do the turtle string.
A different point of view.
I never thought of things that way.
She never thought of things that way.
Now Wednesdays are my favorite day.
Now Wednesdays are our favorite day.
Cause that's the day I'm quite contrary. And now thanks to God and Mary, I have changed to be exact. I love the fact
the world is turning to
let's say you're lost in a park, sure, you can give in to the dark, or you can trip a little light fantastic with me. When you're alone in your room, your choice is just embrace the gloom, or you can trip a little light fantastic with me. For if you hide under the covers, you might never see the day. But if a spark can start inside your heart, then you can always find a way. So when life is getting dreary, just pretend that you're leery as you trip a little light fantastic with me. Now when you're stuck in the mist, sure, you can struggle and resist, or you can trip a little light fantastic with me.
Now say you're lost in the crowd. Well, you can stamp and scream out loud, or you can trip a little I fantastic with me. And when the fog comes rolling in, just keep your feet upon the path. Mustn't mope and frown, or worse, lie down. Don't let it be your epitaph. So when life is getting scary, be your own illuminary, who can shine the light for all the world to see. As you trip a little light fantastic with me. You see, there's nothing to it.
Can you speak Leary Mary Poppins?
Can I speak Leary?
Of course you can. She's Mary Poppins.
Can we do it with you?
Please. Oh, very well, then.
Children, tell us your sorry tale.
Give us your weep and wail.
Well, we had this ball.
Rabbit in the hole.
That fell and broke.
Bicycle spoon.
So we took it to a shop.
Like a lollipop.
And went upside down.
That's a circus clown.
Then went to the bank.
Rattle and clang.
Got lost in the fog.
Lump on a log.
Till we found a friend.
Who stand and defend.
Who took us on a trip.
Snap a horse's whip.
And we took another line fantastic.
Now that sounds a little bit bombastic.
But they tripped the line.
We tripped the line.
Let's trip the line fantastic.
Uncle Gutenberg was a bookworm, and he lived on Charing Cross. The memory of his volumes brings a smile. He would read me lots of stories when he wasn't on the source. Now I'd like to share the wisdom of my favorite bibliophile. He said, discover is not the book, so open it up. Because under the covers one discovers that the king might be a crook.
Chapter titles are like signs,
and if you read between the lines,
you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Oh, give us the one about the dirty rascal, why don't you?
Isn't that one a bit long?
Well, the quicker you're into it, the quicker you're out of it.
Once upon a time in a nursery rhyme, there was a castle with a king hiding in a wing. Because he never went to school to learn a single thing. He had scepters and swords and a parliament of lords, but on the inside he was sad. He had, because he never had a wisdom for numbers, a wisdom for words. Though his crown was quite immense, his brain was smaller than a bird's. So the queen of the nation made a royal proclamation to the missus and the messers, the more the lessers, bring me all the land's professors. Then she went to the hairdressers, and they came from the east, and they came from the south. From each college they put knowledge from their brains into his mouth. But the king couldn't learn, so each professor met their fate, for the queen had the hedgehog who'd been placed upon the gate. And on that date, I stayed their words, I got a note, their mate was now the late great. But then suddenly one day a stranger started in to sing. He said, I'm the dirty rascal and I'm here to teach the king. And the queen clutched the jewels, for she hated royal fools. But this fool had some rules, they really ought to teach in schools. Like, you'll be a happy king if you enjoy the things you've got. You should never try to be the kind of person that you're not. So they sang and they laughed, for the king had found a friend. And they ran onto a rainbow for the story's perfect end. So the moral is, you mustn't let the outside be the guide, for it's not so cut and dried. Well, unless it's Dr. Jekyll, then you better hide. Petrified! No, the truth can't be denied. As I now have testified, all that really counts and matters is the special stuff inside.
Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook.
So please listen to what we've said.
And open a book tonight in bed.
So one more time before we get the hook,
sing it out strong.
A cover is not.
Please take our advice.
A cover is not.
You'll pay the price.
That was act number 734 with Mary Poppins Returns.